All right, this is an audio review for Elizabeth the Golden Girl.
Elizabeth the Golden Age.
Well, I'm waiting for the porno version, Elizabeth the Golden Shower.
Oh, I knew you. I knew somebody was going to do that.
Tom, look at this. This is like a sequel, right? So I never saw the first one because I don't usually like boring movies where everyone dresses funny and nothing happens. But is this like more like a League of Extraordinary Gentlemen thing?
No. See, the thing is first of all, if you haven't seen the original film, go out and rent it. It is incredible. It's the movie that made everyone in the world go, who the hell is Cate Blanchett?
And we're talking about the first Elizabeth.
The first Elizabeth, 1998, the one that got beat out for several Oscars by Shakespeare in Love.
The better movie, which was funny because it was like they had the same cast and the same sets and just say like, look, I got a funny script that can go with this. Let's make this movie instead.
Yeah, well, Elizabeth was an awesome film. And, you know, so I couldn't wait to see this. I know several of you guys are like, really? You went and saw that? But no. I was excited to see it because I love the original. And so I go in and sure enough, it's your typical sequel. You know, Elizabeth, you know, falls in love with a pirate and, you know, they go to war.
Wait a minute, are we talking about this movie here that you saw?
Yeah. But it was awesome. No, I love this movie.
Pirates of the Elizabethan?
Exactly. No. No, you'd think, you know, this is a boring, you know, it's going to be a boring character piece, you know, a period era movie. And how could it possibly be interesting? Well, if you saw the first movie, you know that Jeffrey Rush was a total badass. And Jeffrey Rush went around backstabbing everyone to make sure that Elizabeth was okay. She's, you know, she's his Batman. You know, he comes out of nowhere and, like, solves everything.
Okay, say nothing.
It wasn't me that did it this time.
Lee, we just got on Lee another night. He brings Batman into every review.
Well, I wanted him to have something to say.
And Carlisle's the one who pointed it out, and now here he is doing it.
But you should have seen him light up over here. He's like, he said Batman.
He was Elizabeth's Batman. I mean, he kept the kingdom safe. He was awesome. So, sure enough, he shows up, just comes out of the woodwork here and starts taking care of stuff. He'll just randomly stroll into a torture chamber and get all the information out of a guy, and then we'll cut back to the period movie. But how do they improve it? How do they make it better?
Car chases.
No, better than that.
Sex.
Boobies.
A pirate. And in comes Sir Walter Raleigh, the man god who introduced the world to tobacco. He said, hey, I found something cool in America, and you can smoke it.
So wait a minute. This was like a real pirate?
This
like
is a real guy. He was a well-known trader and adventurer and pirate.
Yes,
and
Corey, there were actually pirates.
I didn't know that.
They weren't just from Peter Pan and Johnny Depp.
Sir Walter Raleigh was known as a pirate. He pirated Spanish vessels, which were, you know, an enemy of the crown, so he felt justified in attacking and looting the enemy. But he was a pirate. So he shows up, and who's playing this pirate? None other than freaking Clive Owen, dude.
Clive Owen?
He's like jumping across the deck with a cannon in each hand in slow motion.
Was he smoking and eating
a carrot?
you know what? He is smoking. He is kicking ass. And there is an action sequence in which he fights the Spanish towards the end.
This don't sound like nothing like the original.
No. The first movie was all about how Elizabeth became queen. This is the movie that's all about all the cool stuff that happened while she was
queen. Oh, it sounds like they said, man, that shit we did the last time was boring. We got to put Clive Owen here in some action.
Like I said, it's a true sequel. They said, how do we ramp this up? Let's blow up more stuff.
This time, it's not just one queen. It's like 80 of them. And Bill Paxton going, we're fucked, man.
See, when you say pirates, I picture like Clive Owen out in the corner. I got these bootleg books, man. Who are these books?
Dude, actually, there is a scene, and I swear to God, they cribbed it right out of Captain Blood, where you see Clive Owen hanging off the bow of the ship and the camera tracks across as the boat's going. And I just sat there giggling like a schoolboy going, I want to see a Clive Owen pirate movie now. I want a Clive Owen pirate movie. But this was pretty damn cool. It's everything that people like about, you know, Oscar-nominated period films. crammed full of stuff for guys like us that love backstabbing intrigue and betrayal and sex and piracy, for Christ's sake. And we have there's a large scene where we actually have, you know, English ships sailing out to attack this huge Spanish armada that's coming to invade England.
Okay, some of this sounds kind of gay, but you can't.
I was going to say, I think this is the first real shot across the bow by the Pink Mafia.
No, but wait, you do have me hooked, though. I mean, so the thing is, you were really praising this movie.
Dude, this movie made history cool.
Well, let me ask you something. Because I thought Pirates of the Caribbean made history cool. I didn't know the difference.
Yeah.
Somebody
yeah.
to tell me.
See, I'm like, here's where the problem lies, Corey. Yeah. This is why you failed history.
Exactly. I thought the Kraken was real. I thought Jack Sparrow was a real person.
This idea of world geography is going to see it's a small world after all. So.
Yeah. But okay, what I'm leading into here is there anything that you didn't like about the movie? Anything you got to criticize about?
You know what? I really there's very little to criticize here. This is a really great film handled with Oscar quality the whole way through. The only thing I could say is people who don't like historical films at all, people who don't like the type of films that get nominated for Oscars, they're going to find this boring until the last third when everything starts blowing up and Elizabeth rides in armor on a big white horse holding a sword in the air. Well, before that, they're going to be, this is all about love and sex.
Whoa. Elizabeth does what? Rides in a suit of armor?
Yeah.
Does it transfer? I mean, does it transform into a VW bug or something?
No.
But there can only be one. So
I mean, it sounds like they took some serious liberties with history.
No, because she doesn't make a badass movie. It's not like she fights. They actually, she's dressed up in the ceremonial leader, you know, armor, because that's what a king went and did. She doesn't go in and
kind of a George Bush thing.
That's why she has Clive Owen.
Okay,
that's funny.
You know something? I have yet to believe that there's anything historical about this shit.
I know.
I think they made this shit up. You know, I mean, it sounds like, I mean, not to say it's not cool. I'm just saying somebody said Pirates of the Caribbean made a lot of money and we want some of that. I don't think this pirate existed.
Yeah, they're already.
You've never heard of Sir Walter Raleigh.
You seriously haven't?
No, he's for real. This guy, everything he's saying about this guy.
Virginia.
Being a crazy pirate and also being like possibly they say the lover to the queen, all that stuff. That's all true.
Yeah, whenever somebody is like a true gentleman to women, they might nickname him Sir Walter Raleigh. Mm-hmm. Like, well,
the guy was a styling motherfucker.
He was the styling motherfucker of his era. He was the George Clooney of the Elizabethan era.
Look, I ain't gonna lie to you. I didn't know when you said Sir Riley. I thought you were talking about Riley off the Boondocks or something.
Riley.
Okay, but I'm all mixed
Raleigh,
up.
Raleigh, as in the city. Which was named after.
Okay. Well, look. Hey, look at this.
Damn, Corey, read a book.
Or better yet, go see the movie. Because really, this is history made cool. It's a lot of fun, and it's good. I mean, I can watch Kate Blanchett read the phone book.
Well, I'm sorry, dude. Right now, it sounds like this movie is about as accurate as Shrek.
But then again, keep in mind that I am talking up the parts that I think everyone's going to enjoy. There are periods where people are sitting around and talking, and there is, you know, there's. It is a historical epic, so there's historical things that go on.
Well, I give this movie full price without even seeing it because I learned something. Well, I haven't even stepped foot in the theater yet, and I feel like I'll have a history lesson already.
And knowing's half the battle.
Look, this is Clive Owen, man. What more do you need to know to get your ass into a theater? Nothing. Clive Owen playing a pirate from history. I mean, we keep calling him a pirate, and Sir Walter Raleigh is probably, you know, in the afterlife going, I wasn't a fucking pirate, all right? God damn it, wasn't a pirate. I attacked a few Spanish ships. Everyone has to call me up. They keep calling me a pirate.
He was a pirate to the Spanish.
Yeah. See, that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking Sir Walter Raleigh wasn't even a pirate. I think he was just some dude who walked around, you know, probably weighed 90 pounds. Talking shit all the time. He's probably a poet. He probably never stepped foot on a ship.
A poet.
Okay, you know what? Wait, you're gonna question the guy who doesn't know history at all? You think he's a poet? No, he doesn't know shit. He's talking out his ass right now.
I don't think the people that wrote this script. I don't think they knew history either because this shit sounds bogus.
You've never heard of countries going to war?
You know, some cool shit happened once, or actually about 12, probably about 10,000 times a long time ago, and they haven't made movies about all of it yet. But this is one of those movies, from what I hear.
Look, okay, let me let me lay this down for you for those who are doubting. How many English rulers can you count that you know of?
None.
No, you know a couple.
Okay.
But real ones. The ones like you've heard of. Like it, you know, people have heard of Henry VIII, and people have heard of Elizabeth, and people have heard of, you know,
King
you
George.
Just hit the complete list.
I just hit pretty much the complete list. We don't talk about Henry's 1 through 7.
What about King Richard and Robin Hood? Richard the Lionheart
existed. There's four.
See, I know a little something.
But there's
there
a
was
reason,
no Robin Hood.
There's a reason why we've heard of all these people.
Was he a fox like he was in that Disney movie?
Yes, he was.
Was he an actual lion?
It was. He was born that way. We don't like to talk about it.
Okay. No, honestly, this
It was actually Sean Connery. He showed up and he was Sean Connery.
No, okay. We're clowning around, but I really do think, I mean, you saw me on the movie. I did like the first Elizabeth. I really did.
If you did, you will like this one. This one picks up right where the last one left off. You have to have seen it to understand everything that's going on because it uses all the same actors. Okay. You know, Jeffrey Rush walks in and starts doing stuff again. You're like, oh, dude, it's him. Oh, what's he going to do? And he's just as awesome as he was last
Barbarossa!
Time.
Barbarossa! So no,
Barbarossa.
Barbarossa, whatever.
Barbarossa.
I don't know. Yeah, don't try to sit up here talk about me. Yeah, God
well,
punished
you. Well, that wasn't history.
Oh, bullshit.
They didn't teach Pirates in the Caribbean in the school Barbarossa. I went to.
I know who Barbarossa is.
Yeah?
No, I don't know. That's that chick in that movie, that Space Age movie, right?
No.
That's the ranch.
That's the Ponderosa, you moron.
No, duh. The Ponderosa is where they serve steak, asshole.
Indeed.
I thought y'all were talking about Barbarella.
No, it was Vinnie Barbarino.
At least some ignorant motherfucker.
Vinnie Barbarino, that's exactly it. The queen was sitting there going, up your nose with the rubber hose.
The queen, she's so weird.
Oh, it's the type of drug they used to do in the 70s.
All right.
That's enough. Imbecile.
Oh, full price.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, you know what? I absolutely give it full price. And you know what? You're going to be, you know what? They're going to give Kate Blanchett her honorary yearly Oscar nomination now. It's like, okay, you played Elizabeth again. Here's your nomination. Maybe we'll luck out and she'll win this time. Who knows?
Cool. Well, good for her. You might learn something before it's done. Hey.